Today I want to go ahead and show you the tips and tricks on how I go retouching my holiday light photographs. And this was done in the old Lightroom CC. First off, when taking this photograph, I had a tripod with me. It's the only way I could really pull off the sharpness and everything. And my settings on this, let me pull these up real quick for you. So my settings were 1.3 seconds. My aperture at 7.1. So a good little secret is try not to go below 7.1 aperture when you're shooting these kind of photographs. And that's usually when you got quite a bit of lights and buildings that might be lit up. And that'll actually help get your photograph a little more sharp. If you start dropping below the aperture of 7.1, then you start to kind of lose your sharpness and it's really hard to bring back even in Lightroom. And then I had my ISO set at 400. And I actually only used a kit lens that came with my camera, the DSLR Nikon. And what I did was I did a manual focus with it because at nighttime or when it's kind of darker situations like this, the autofocus sometimes will just jump in and out. So I strongly recommend just put it into manual and then go ahead and do some test shots. And then after I do a test shot, I actually go onto my camera screen there and zoom in real close just to make sure everything looks sharp. And then the last tip I want to give you is I always shoot in RAW format instead of JPEG. And that definitely gives you a lot of good editing power when it comes to Lightroom or Photoshop. And let me show you what the original shot looked like. So right here, you're going to see the before. Everything's looking really flat, not much color in it. And even the background Christmas lights here actually look a little blown out, but we'll be fixing all that. And this is the aftermath right here. So let's go ahead and get started on this. Let me go ahead and hit the reset button right here. Okay, so the first thing I want to do is I definitely want to try to get these lights to not look so bright here. So I'm going to come over here to the highlights, and I'm just going to go ahead and drop it down. And usually this does a pretty good job of getting everything down, so you got to be careful when you are shooting not to try to overexpose everything, because if it's too overexposed, even dropping the highlights is going to be tough to try to get the colors and everything. Now the next thing I want to do, I'm just going to barely bring my shadows up on this one. And the idea for this is I'm just trying to light up just a little more of the sky here. Now for the whites, I'm actually going to hold down my option key on my Mac, which is Alt on your Windows. And I want to do is I'm going to blow out the Christmas lights. So all those white dots you see in the black there, are you're basically taking the Christmas lights and you're blowing them out just a little bit. And that's actually going to make them pop a little bit better. Same thing with the blacks. I'm going to once again hold my option key on the Mac, Alt on your Windows. And I'm going to back down the blacks just a little bit. Now here on clarity, I'm just going to go ahead and just bump this just to about 7. Vibrance and saturation I will come back to. Now under the tab HSL color and black and white, once again I want to be under the saturation. And I'm going to do is just bump up a couple of these colors just a little bit. And I could get real good individual control with each one of these. So I'm just kind of looking at the picture as I'm going along and I'll adjust these up and down. Now the next thing I want to do is I really want to sharpen this building up and some of this foreground. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to bump this all the way up to about 70. And then I want to do is I don't want to sharpen these dark areas. So once again, I'm going to hold my option key down on the Mac, and it'll be Alt on Windows, and I'm going to bring this over, and I'm looking at the blacks here. I just want to make sure the blacks stay solid and all the black areas not getting sharpened. I'm going to let up. So now we got a building that looks really sharp here. But there is one setback when you do sharpen things up, is you can start creating noise. So let me go ahead and zoom in here. And as you can see, hopefully it shows up on the video here, that this is starting to look really grainy with a little bit of noise on here. So to fix that, I'm actually going to go right under noise reduction, and I'm going to pull the luminance key up. And I'm going to kind of watch the building here where everything kind of smooths out. And you want to be careful not to overdo this because it can look really pasty looking. So I'm just going to take it up just a little bit here. And it looks like about 40 does the trick. So let me zoom back out. So now I'm going to go ahead and scroll down. And I do want to enable the profile correction for this one. It's not going to make too big of a difference since the lens I was using doesn't have much of a fisheye, but every little bit does help. Now under transform, I'm going to put this on auto, which should help that building out. And as you can see, it does make a difference on the building as I click on and off it. So I'll go ahead and keep that on auto. Now here's another cool trick. Under effects, under highlight priority, you want to make sure you're under that. We want to go ahead and I'm going to bump the amount upwards to about 5. And what we're doing is we're kind of putting a softer light look. So let me just kind of bring it up real big time. You can see what's happening here. Bring it back. So the idea is I just want a real soft look around the edges here. It just kind of gives it a little more holiday feel to it. I think 7's a little too much. I think I'm going to leave about 5. And then once again, under dehaze, let's just go ahead and just bump that up just a little bit. And you could actually even soften this up a little bit if you go down to -5, but I'm gonna go ahead and bring this up to about a +5. So the next thing we wanna do, here's where some of the really cool effects come in. So I'm gonna come right here where it says adjustment brush. Let's click on that. I'm gonna hold my option key down. So right here where it says effects on the corner here, if you push down your alt key on your Windows or option key on Mac, you'll see it'll say reset. So once you push down, it says reset. I always like to reset everything. And that actually freshens everything up back to 0. Now what I want to do is I'm going to take the exposure up to about, say about 40. I'm going to come over to the building here and I'm going to scroll down the wheel on my mouse here. And I'm going to make this real small here. Now this is really a cool little trick. This is going to help make your buildings pop. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm just going to do a little paint up and down a little bit here. And I'm just going to do a couple verticals on these windows. And I'm going to show you what's going to happen here in just a second. I'm going to paint a little bit on the front. Kind of come over here. And getting a little creative with the brush here, you could do some pretty cool stuff. And people look at your photographs wondering, what the heck, that building looks really cool. Okay, so once I did my little paint job here, I'm going to go ahead and back to exposure. And I'm going to bump this up a little bit higher. And as you can see, look at the building. And I'm just going to kind of way overdo it and underdo it a little bit so you can see what's going on here, this effect. So just by using this brush here, filter, you could really make your buildings pop. This is such a cool thing to do, and I use this a lot. The other one I like to use is the radial filter. So let me just click on that one. Once again, I'm going to hold my option key down, reset, and that's your alt key on Windows. I'm going to bump up my exposure to probably 41... Let's go about 50 on this one. And let me just kind of create a little bit of light. And I'm making a couple filters here in the snow. And I just kind of want to light it up just a little bit there, but just make it pop a little bit. Now, as you notice, because I did drop all the highlights down, it did kind of mess up this light here. It doesn't look quite right. So I'm actually going to make a filter across this. Just kind of get it to fit. And then I'm going to go ahead and take the highlights and bring the highlights up. As you can see, it fixes the light there to where it looks more normal and natural. And then once I'm done with that, I'll just hit done. You know, look at this picture. I just want to do one more touch up. I just kind of want to make it pop just a little bit more. So I'm going to go, once again, I'm going to go back to the radial filter. I'm going to bring the exposure down to about 42. I'm going to come and make a really big one here that just kind of goes over the whole picture, or a good portion of it. And the idea here is I'm trying to get the viewer, as they see the photo, just to kind of, it just kind of zeroes in towards this building. So now what I want to do is I'm going to take these highlights down just a little bit more, play with the exposure just a tad. So I think I'm going to take the exposure to about 32. And then I'm going to bump the clarity up just a little bit more here. So I'm going to go about 15 on the clarity. Then I'm going to hit done. Now the very last thing I'm going to do here, I just want to go under the vibrance and saturation. So let's just kind of make the colors pop just a little bit. So let's take the vibrance up to about 10. And saturation, I'm going to take that to about 7. And there's the pretty much a complete picture. I mean, there's a lot of times I'll maybe go into a little more detail, but that's just kind of gives you a ballpark on how to go about retouching your holiday lights here. So anyways, I hope this video helped you out. If it did, definitely hit that like button down below. Feel free to share the video with anybody you think this could help them out. And definitely subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet. So we'll get you guys on the next video.